I will talk about eco-design, environmentally conscious design. Eco-design has been studied and practiced since early 1990s. In early days, eco-design meant to design products for adding environmentally conscious features, including design for disassembly, design for recycling, design for maintenance, selecting eco-materials, and so on. Eco-design is very important since carefully eco-designed products drastically reduce costs and increase environmental efficiency throughout their life cycles. For example, it is very difficult to disassemble a component in which different materials are glued firmly. But if you apply a design for disassembly, materials will be connected with snap fit instead of adhesive agents, and it will be very easy to disassemble. The second generation of eco-design started around the year of 2000. It was turned out that designing products is not enough, but we should design product life cycles at the same time. For example, even though design for disassembly is well applied to a washing machine in design stage, the washing machine is just shredded without disassembly at the end of its life. Such a contradiction often happens. Designing product life cycles is called life cycle design, and this is the intersection of life cycle engineering and eco-design. The third generation of eco-design is now emerging. I believe the third generation of eco-design should incorporate change of people's perception of value from ownership value to experience value, change of lifestyle including sharing economy, and change of social system including circular economy. In addition, the scope of eco-design should be expanded just from environment to various goals described in SDGs. These trends are intensively discussed in life cycle engineering. Next, I will talk about the barriers. Eco-design, or design in general, is just an embodiment process of your concepts and ideas. Then, if a company does not have a firm decision on shifting from mass production and mass sales to life cycle business, eco-design cannot work. So leadership of top executive is the most important prerequisite of the success of eco-design. Thank you very much for your attention.